quite.
Yes. Sorry?
The caucus mountains.
Caucus mountains. And also, in the United States and in the whole world, Asian means white. Both white race and beautiful. But why do they call white people to take it? Yes, exactly. So, Georgia is exactly where the maybe considered as a homosexual behavior.
Oh, And finally, as a tradition, marinera norteña.
Thank you.
word Puente says the word. Yeah.
Yes. There's an African dance band which is foreign dance. And what were they doing? So dancing.
They look like they were playing the guitar.
Maybe the idea. Do you see the women like spreading their hands and open to men? And I think that means that, you know, this is the an ancient Ugandan dance, and like what was happening in old Uganda was that like several men could share one woman, and there were times where like five or six brothers had one wife that they shared. And I think that this is somehow showing that so many women like open to everyone. So this is my interpretation. And as I want to show you dances from all kinds of the world, but I didn't pick up about the United States. And I want you to ask me for help, because it's kind of hard for me, because you are so knowledgeable in that area. So I need your ideas, like when I go to Europe or Africa someday and lecture there about nonverbal cues and about the dances that show the history of the culture, what should I pick up? Which dance? Yes? Break dancing? It's interesting.
Swing.
Sorry?
Swing.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you for those ideas. Yes, do you want to?
I was just going to say, like, it's impossible if they want.
Yeah, that's why I couldn't. Okay. And you know that in nonverbal communication, there are some vocal cues that the scientists call paralanguage, and this means that different cultures have different vocal cues, and even with the accent of a person, you can understand where is he or she coming from. So I prepared a short one, a funny video for you that shows this very well.
No, I'm going to have another, actually.
What matter?
Well, with all the international CEOs from around the world in this room. In 10 minutes, the annual summit is supposed to take place. They've traveled thousands of miles to get here, and my translator hasn't turned up. I need to find someone who can translate into seven different languages.
Well, I can do that. Yeah, I can do Tepelin, we'll get you.
Welcome back to London, ladies and gentlemen. This is Helen Marsh, who will be our interpreter today. So, without further ado, let's address section 1.1, multinational profiteering for the financial year 2005-2006. Helen.
Bug, bug, bug.
pretty good in London, actually.